Hello, today we're going to go over setting up a connection with Enterprise Alert and the Network Node Manager I, or NNMI. Our first step is inside of the NNMI user interface, we need to set up a specific user for Enterprise Alert. In order to do that, we need to go under Configuration, and then expand out Security, and then click on the User Accounts. We need to create a new user inside of here, and we'll create a new user, give it the name EA User, and give it a password for your system that you will remember. Once that user is created, go back to the user account screen and open up your new EA user. And on this screen, we want to make sure that the EA user is a member of specifically the NNMI Web Service Clients user group. This user group specifically contains the rights needed to hook your NNMI instance up to your EA instance. Once we have this user set up and ready to go, then we can go ahead and access our Enterprise Alert software. Inside the Enterprise Alert software, our first step needs to be that we need to add the NNMI event source. So we're going to go ahead and click on System, and then we're going to click on the Event Sources button. Inside of here, we want to click on the New Source. We're going to choose the HP Network Node Manager from the dropdown. This is the NNMI interface from the dropdown. So inside here, we're going to give it a name for the host or web service URL, enter in the URL to access the system, and then enter in the EA user and the password that you gave to the EA user inside of the NNMI service. After that, click on the Save button. Then back on the Event Sources screen, you'll see the new NNMI event source. It should appear with a blue OK versus an orange for an unknown error or a gray for a disabled. Once the event source shows and is selected as blue, now we will read new events from the NNMI system on our Enterprise Alert system. Now that my NNMI event source is set up, any events that come from the NNMI service will show up inside of my Enterprise Alert. So if I go to Alerts and into Incoming Events, I will now see a new NNMI event come through. And then you can create a policy from this event for your system to push out the events to whoever on your team needs to be aware of them. So if I go ahead and click on Create Policy from Event, I will open up a new alert policy, which I can name anything you need to. From everything's coming from the NNMI event source, and then I click on the next button, and here you'll have all of the information inside the event source, and you can take out whatever you don't need, add whatever you might need inside of this. For my purposes, I am going to cut down on a number of these conditions. Okay, so we're going to leave that the alert is new, that the alert is coming from node named APO2 for our case, and that the node status is critical. From there, we're going to choose a team or user to switch it to. For my purposes, I'm just going to send it straight to this one user, and we're going to send it via email, just so that it's easier for me to keep track of on this test server. And inside of my subject, I'm going to enter in some dynamic content. So we're going to create a new alert with the messages, with the title for node name, so APO1 is unreachable. And then in the body, we're going to put in the status, take the severity from the parameters, as well as the node name again, and it's unreachable at time, and then we're going to put the time raised for the incident, so it'll say when the service became unreachable. And then we're going to go ahead and save and close that. And now that this new NNMI event policy is in place, anytime a new NNMI event comes in that meets our criteria, it'll automatically trigger the new NNMI event policy. This in turn sends an email to our administrative user with the information from the alert. And that is how we connect the NNMI monitoring system to the EA alerting system. Thank you and have a great day. Goodbye.